Hello, fellow Year 11s. As you could see, I'm about to do my speaking exam just like you. I've got here a bit early, so I'm just using this time to look over my speaking answers before I go into my exam. Okay.
Hello.
Hi, miss.
Good morning, Mr. Orm. Would you like to follow me? Just may I ask you, have you got your phone in your bag?
Yeah, it's turned off.
Right.
I've just put my notes in my bag as well.
Okay, so I've got here two raffle tickets, okay? So you want one raffle ticket for being here present for the exam,
Thank you.
Then you have another raffle ticket for being here on time. And the reason why we're doing that is because you'll be put in a draw and there'll be a prize given out. So, you've got 12 minutes to prepare. Please, you've got there your photo card and your role play. Please do not write on the sheets. You have there the written paper.
Okay, thank you, miss.
Okay. Good luck.
Ready? Right, I'm going to prepare my role play first. So I've got my 5 bullet points on here, okay? I make sure I read the rubric at the top. So my teacher's playing the part of my Peruvian friend and will speak first, okay? And I remember that this means I've got to say something that I haven't prepared. This means I have to ask a question, okay? So the first one, I'm only going to give an opinion and a reason about doing obligatory compulsory subjects. So I'm going to put... No me gusta porque es aburrido. I'm not going to say too much because I don't need to give more detail than what's required on there. I won't get any extra marks for it, so there's no point in doing it. Importancia de aprender español, una razón. I'm going to say es importante. Again, I'm not going to be fancy on the role play. I'm just going to say what I need to say. The next one is the exclamation mark. I'm going to actually write that exclamation mark there, because if I don't, I might think that Miss is asking me that one when she's actually asking me that one. So I'll make sure the exclamation mark's on. Your ideal teacher, two details, okay? Mi profesor ideal es simpático. Pero no es estricto. Okay, and then that one means I need to ask my teacher a question about examines en el colegio. I can't just make up any random question for that. It has to be about that. So I'm going to say, te gustan. Exámenes. So now I'm doing my photo. I've turned over from the other side just in case I get confused between the photo card and the role play. So I'm going to put PC for photo card. I need to answer these three questions that are printed on the front of the card. Now, in total, I have 5 questions. I've got these three and another 2 that Miss is going to ask me on the same topic. I need to fully develop 3 answers out of the 5 to get full marks. I need to answer all 5 correctly. The easiest 3 to develop are these 3 that are printed on the front. So I'm going to put photo card. ¿Qué hay en la foto? Just 3 things I can see in the photo. So I'm going to say, en la foto hay un profe. Hay niños. And I might say something about how they look. They look to me like they might be quite happy. So I'm going to say, están felices. 3 pieces of information. I don't want to put it all in one sentence because then it only counts as one. So I don't want to say, hay un profe y niños. I do those as 2 separate sentences. Okay, the next one. There's always one in the past or the future. Okay, so ¿qué trabajo querías hacer cuando eras más joven? So the ER there shows me that it's used to. If you remember, ABBA and IA, you know, I used to listen to Mamma Mia by ABBA, has that IA ending. So I'm going to say, quería ser profe. What job did I want to do? I wanted to be a teacher. Porque es un trabajo muy interesante. I've got two details here. I wanted to be a teacher because it's a very interesting job. I need another one. Pero también, but also, es un poco estresante. It's a bit stressful. There we go, three details on that. I'm on for 4 marks so far. And then the last one, ¿cuáles son las ventajas de ser profesor? I'm going to say, ser profesor, being a teacher, I need to say something about the advantages. Ser profesor es un trabajo variado. It's a varied job. Y hay muchas oportunidades. And there are lots of opportunities. Okay, and then I need something else. Got two things, need something else. Okay. También las vacaciones. The holidays son largas. The holidays are long. Whatever you say on these questions, you just need to say three things about each one. And then I only have to answer the two surprise ones with a correct answer. It doesn't need to be a developed answer. So there we go, I'm on for 4 marks. So. Done.
Okay, Mr. Orme, if you'd like to follow me, we'll go to the exam.
Yeah.
Can I have your tickets, please?
Yeah. I'm glad I got two tickets. That gives me two chances to win the gift card.
GCSE Spanish speaking exam, April 2023. Higher tier, centre number 28116, candidate name Mr. Orme, candidate number 1234, role play number 11 and photo card letter O, general conversation chosen by candidate theme 3. Okay, muy bien, empezamos con el juego de rol.
So she's just said we're starting with the role play and I can read my notes from my prepared sheet. Let's skip forward a little bit.
A few minutes later.
¿Y ahora la foto?
So now it's time for the photo card. Just like the role play, I can read out the notes that I've prepared on my sheet. Apart from the final two that Miss will ask me that are unprepared ones, but they'll always be on the same topic as the other three. The photo card lasts 2 minutes on foundation and 3 minutes on higher. But I'm not going to worry about that because Miss will keep an eye on the time and make sure I don't run over.
A few minutes later.
¿Me pasas tus notas y tarjetas? Gracias. Y ahora la conversación. Vamos a empezar con el tema número 3. ¿Qué te gusta estudiar en el instituto?
Me gusta mucho estudiar español porque es útil y la profesora es muy simpática. Sin embargo, no me gusta la religión. ¿Y tú? You see what I did there? I managed to get in my question right away. Miss asked me the question and then I just said, ¿y tú? And that means that's the requirement for the question met in the general conversation.
A few minutes later.
¿Tienes alguna pregunta para mí?
So that's just in case I forget to ask a question at any point during that conversation. Miss can prompt me to ask a question by saying, do you have a question for me? So I'm just going to say something simple like, ¿te gusta el español?
Sí, me encanta el español. End of test.